Now we're going to go over the suffixes, which usually play a different role. And just to get out of the way, remember how I mentioned earlier, be can be used as a possessive suffix, but it's very rarely. So far we've been dealing with root nouns. In order to get a verb, you take the root noun and you add a suffix. The verb from that root noun, you add a vowel. Normally that vowel will be I. However, it's possible to have an A, an O, or a U. It's just more rare. I is the most common. It won't be an E, however, which I will go over later. So to make your root into a verb, you add I or another vowel. To make it into the infinitive version, you add that vowel and then an R. So you have your root and you add a vowel, it's a verb. If you add an R after that vowel, then it's an infinitive. That vowel should not be an E. For example, allure means leader. It's the root noun. If you add an I to the end, it becomes allure, which is the verb lead. If you add an R, it's allurier, which becomes the infinitive to lead. So just to cover that up again, you have your vowel and an R. That vowel is usually an I, not an E, and you put that vowel and that R on the end of the root, you have your infinitive. If there's no R, it's just a regular old verb. Remember how I said you can't have that B and E? The reason you cannot have that vowel for your verb B and E is because E is used for the plural of your root. If you add an E to the end of your root, and sometimes you'll put a baten between it, which was that apostrophe, if you remember, you make that root into a plural. In certain cases, the plural will be SE with your apostrophe sometimes. And there are some other rare pluralizations, but I'm not going to go over it in this one. So if you add an E or an SE, that makes it a plural root. And sometimes it's separated by your apostrophe. Ika, your diminutive suffix, meaning it makes it a smaller form of the root. Kind of like ori, except the opposite. It makes it small and less important rather than big and important. So orivod is your big brother. Vodika is your little brother, which yes, sounds like vodka. In order to turn your nouns, your root nouns, into adjectives and adverbs, which in Mando'a there is no distinction between either, there's just whatever is connected to it makes it an adjective or an adverb, you need to add one of two suffixes. They are based on pronunciation, whichever you like, however there are some suggestions, but you're not required to follow them, which you'll see in some of my examples. The first one is la, apostrophe la, which comes after the root, making it into an adjective or an adverb. These are suggested to go after roots with vowels on the end, but you'll see in my example, again, it's not always. Dikutla means stupid, or literally someone who forgets their pants. Dikut is an idiot, someone who forgets their pants. And you add the la to the end, which, even though it's a T, I still added la because that's what most people do, and it's generally accepted. Even though it's not a vowel, I don't have to use la. My other ending is apostrophe YC, ish. This comes after a root that's usually ending in a consonant, but it doesn't have to. It's not enforced. However, there are certain ones which are used most often, but you don't have to follow it if you don't want to. For example, kot ish is the adjective form of kot, which means strength. Kot ish is strong. That should be enough for the affixes.